Ethics guidance for research involving human participants has been developed and disseminated by numerous organizations and agencies at international, regional, and national levels over the past 50 years. Adherence to these guidelines helps to promote the ethical conduct of research and enhances and protects the rights and well-being of research participants and communities. A core component of all contemporary research ethics guidelines is that research should be subject to prior ethical review by a competent institutional review board or IRB. Such review is intended to ensure that the ethical principles and practices put forward in the guidelines will be followed in the proposed research. IRBs may review different types of research studies, including, but not limited to, the following: clinical trials, epidemiological research, social science research, research on medical records or other personal information, research on stored samples, health systems research, and implementation research. IRBs should be familiar with the different methodologies and ethical considerations that apply to each type of proposed research they review. The IRB is constituted according to a charter or other document that establishes the manner in which members and the chair will be appointed. The appointing entity ensures that the IRB has a multidisciplinary and multisectoral membership, that its composition is gender balanced, that it reflects the social and cultural diversity of the communities from which research participants are most likely to be drawn, and that it includes individuals with backgrounds relevant to the areas of research the committee is most likely to review. The entity establishing the IRB takes the following factors into consideration when appointing members: individuals with scientific expertise, including expertise in behavioral or social sciences, healthcare providers, and members who have expertise in legal matters or ethics; lay people and other members whose primary background is not in health research with human participants. Their primary role is to share their insights about the communities from which participants are likely to be drawn. Lay people are appointed to sufficient numbers to ensure that they feel comfortable voicing their views. In order to enhance independence, board membership also includes members who are not affiliated with organizations that sponsor, fund, or conduct research reviewed by the IRB. IRB need to ensure that the committees are large enough to ensure that multiple perspectives are brought into the discussion. To this end, quorum requirements provide that at least 5 people, including at least 1 lay member and 1 non-affiliated member, are present to make decisions about the proposed research. The entity establishing the IRB supports it with adequate resources, including staffing, facilities, and financial resources to allow the IRB to effectively carry out its responsibilities. As an integral part of a health research institution or health system, an IRB receives support staff, adequate in number and training to enable the IRB to carry out its technical and administrative responsibilities; adequate resources for the staff to fulfill its assigned functions, including office space and equipment and supplies, such as computers, stationery, telephones, photocopying machines, shredding machine and etc., to conduct administrative business, to store committee files, and to keep documents secure and confidential; access to appropriate space for the committee to meet and adequate means for members to communicate as needed between meetings; adequate financial resources to permit the committee to produce high-quality work; and resources necessary to compensate IRB members, unless they are already being compensated for their time and effort on the IRB through other means. Policies governing the IRB include mechanisms to ensure independence of the IRB's operations in order to protect decision-making from influence by any individual or entity that sponsors, conducts, or hosts the research it reviews. Such policies provide at a minimum that IRB members, including the chair, remove themselves from the review of any research in which they or close family members have a conflicting interest. To ensure that the IRB cannot be pressured to approve or disapprove particular protocols, the charter, bylaws, policies, or procedural rules of the IRB provide that the IRB's membership includes at least 1 person with no connection to the organization that sponsors or conducts the research under review. Researchers, sponsors, and funders may attend an IRB meeting to answer questions about their research protocols and associated documents, but they are not present when the IRB reaches decisions about their proposed research. senior decision-makers of the entity creating the IRB, or of any organization that sponsors or conducts the research reviewed by the IRB, such as the director of an institution or his or her agent, do not serve as members of the IRB or its chair. And the entity that establishes the IRB ensures that IRB members are protected from retaliation based on positions taken with respect to IRB-related matters or review of research projects. Training on the ethical aspects of health-related research with human participants, how ethical considerations apply to different types of research, and how the IRB conducts its review of research, is provided to IRB members when they join the committee and periodically during their committee service. The training provided to IRB members, either directly by the appointing entity or through cooperative arrangements with other IRBs or organizations that provide education on research ethics, focuses on the role and responsibilities of the IRB and its role vis-à-vis other relevant entities, according to relevant international guidelines, such as International Council on Harmonization Good Clinical Practice, or ICHGCP, national laws, and institutional policies. The full range of ethical considerations relevant to research with human participants. The application of such ethical considerations to different types of research. Basic aspects of research methodology and design for members who lack such background. The impact of different scientific designs and objectives on the ethics of a research study. And the various approaches for recognizing and resolving the tensions that can arise among different ethical considerations and modes of ethical reasoning. When training is supported by research sponsors, mechanisms are in place to ensure that the sponsor has no control, direct or indirect, over the content of the training. Mechanisms exist to make IRB operations transparent, accountable, consistent, and of high quality. The entity establishing the IRB employs reliable means to evaluate whether the staff and members of the IRB routinely follow the IRB's policies, rules, and written procedures, with special attention to whether the ethical considerations articulated in international guidelines and national standards are being considered and applied consistently and coherently. Such evaluations are conducted by knowledgeable and unbiased people at regular, predefined intervals using a predefined format. The results of the evaluation are of a type that can aid the IRB in reviewing its practice and appraising performance, rather than apportioning blame, while also assuring the public that research is being reviewed according to established standards. Researchers, research participants, and other interested parties have a means of lodging complaints about the IRB. Such complaints should be reviewed by an entity other than the IRB itself, and appropriate follow-up actions should be taken. Researchers also have a means of discussing concerns with IRB members, both on general matters and in response to IRB decisions on particular research studies. IRB decisions, excluding confidential information, are made publicly available through mechanisms such as clinical trial registries, websites, newsletters, and bulletin boards. The primary task of an IRB is the ethical review of research protocols and their supporting documents. Approval or disapproval is based on the ethical acceptability of the research, including scientific design and conduct of the study. Research is ethically acceptable only if it relies on valid scientific methods. IRBs should have documentation from a prior scientific review, or should themselves determine that the research methods are scientifically sound, and should examine the ethical implications of the chosen research design or strategy. Unless already determined by a prior scientific review, IRBs should also assess how the study will be conducted, the qualifications of the researchers, the adequacy of provisions made for monitoring and auditing, as well as the adequacy of the study site, such as the availability of qualified staff and appropriate infrastructures. Risks and potential benefits. In ethically acceptable research, risks have been minimized, both by preventing potential harms and minimizing their negative impacts should they occur, and are reasonable in relation to the potential benefits of the study. IRB members should be aware that risks may occur in different dimensions, such as physical, social, financial, or psychological, and harm may occur either at an individual level or at the family or population level. Selection of study population and recruitment of research participants. Ethically acceptable research ensures that no group or class of persons bears more than its fair share of the burdens of participation in research. Similarly, no group should be deprived of its fair share of the benefits of research. These benefits include the direct benefits of participation, as well as the new knowledge that the research is designed to yield. Thus, one question for research ethics review to consider is whether the population that will bear the risks of participating in the research is likely to benefit from the knowledge derived from the research. In addition, ethically acceptable research includes recruitment strategies that are balanced and objectively describe the purpose of the research, the risks and potential benefits of participating in the research, and other relevant details. Inducements, financial benefits, and financial costs. It is considered ethically acceptable and appropriate to reimburse individuals for any costs associated with participation in research, including transportation, child care, or lost wages. Many IRBs also believe that it is ethically acceptable to compensate participants for their time. However, payments should not be so large, or free medical care or other forms of compensation so extensive, as to induce prospective participants to consent to participate in the research against their better judgment or to compromise their understanding of the research. Protection of research participants' privacy and confidentiality. Invasions of privacy and breaches of confidentiality are disrespectful to participants and can lead to feelings of loss of control or embarrassment, as well as tangible harms such as social stigma, rejection by families or communities, or lost opportunities such as employment or housing. IRB should therefore examine the precautions taken to safeguard participants' privacy and confidentiality. Informed consent process. The ethical foundation of informed consent is the principle of respect for persons. Competent individuals are entitled to choose freely whether to participate in research and to make decisions based on an adequate understanding of what the research entails. Decisions for children or adults who lack the mental capacity to provide informed consent should be made by an authorized surrogate decision maker. IRB should examine the process through which informed consent will occur, as well as the information that will be provided. IRBs may waive the requirement of informed consent only when doing so is consistent with international guidelines and national standards. While informed consent to research is important, the fact that a participant or surrogate may be willing to consent to research does not, in itself, mean that the research is ethically acceptable. And finally, community considerations. Research has impacts not only on the individuals who participate, but also on the communities where the research occurs and or to whom findings can be linked. Duties to respect and protect communities require examining by the IRB and, as far as possible, are aimed at minimizing any negative effects on communities such as stigma or draining of local capacity and promoting, as relevant, positive effects on communities, including those related to health effects or capacity development. Researchers should actively engage with communities in decision-making about the design and conduct of research, including the informed consent process, while being sensitive to and respecting the community's cultural, traditional, and religious practices. Decisions on research protocols designated for review by the convened IRB are based on a thorough and inclusive process of discussion and deliberation. Protocols involving no more than minimal risk and burden to research participants may be reviewed on an expedited basis by one or more members, rather than the full committee, if the IRB has established written procedures permitting such a procedure. During meetings of the IRB, members engage in discussions to elicit all concerns and opinions related to the protocols and the associated documents under consideration. The IRB's rules ensure that the discussions are respectful of all opinions and allow for varied beliefs to be aired. Decisions are made only by those who were present during the entire discussion. The chair is responsible for the decision-making process. Researchers, funders, or others directly associated with the protocol in question are not present during committee deliberations. IRB members recognize the limitations of their knowledge and can seek external input when necessary. Decisions are arrived at through either a vote or consensus. Consensus does not require that all IRB members support the decision, but that all members consider the decision at least acceptable and no member considers the decision unacceptable.